I think it's pretty insane that Dragon Ball FighterZ isn't actually done. More than anything, it's not just the fact that, oh, there's a new character. It's more the fact that there's a new character and there might potentially even be more. That's really crazy. So yes, Android 21 is getting an alternate version. Some people were legit telling me this isn't a new character. I'm like, I'm pretty sure it is. They're like, oh, it's just a lab coat. I'm like, wait. Would you also say that DiCaprio in Street Fighter 4 is not a new character because it's just another version of Cammy? Yes! You know, like, no, those are different characters, right? They are. They might not have the budget of other characters, but they are different characters in the same way that Kilgore is a different character than Fulgore in Killer Instinct, right? That's the deal here. This isn't a costume. It's not a costume. She is going to play differently, right? She is going to be the human version of the character. I wish they didn't call her Lab Coat. I think that's kind of weird to call the character Lab Coat. I think they should have just called it Human 21 or something like that. But aside from the character itself, I think the more interesting part of the conversation is they're actually making more characters for Dragon Ball FighterZ, right? So it's been about a year since there has been a substantial update to Dragon Ball FighterZ. I think the last one happened earlier this year. The fact that there is actually still new content for the game is pretty crazy to me because it felt like the game was already sort of on the way out. Come to a elemental conclusion of the game and are sort of like wrapping things up in some way, which is pretty crazy that they're still putting development time and resources into Dragon Ball FighterZ. And here's the thing, I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I don't know if I want them to treat this thing like it's Xenoverse 2, you know? They could potentially be doing that. They could be treating this game like it is an eventual Xenoverse 2, because I have some bad news. There is a very low likelihood that Bandai Namco would put up the money for a netcode update in the current version of Dragon Ball FighterZ. For a game that came out in 2018, a three, soon to be, damn. Are we soon to be 4-year-old fighting game? We are, damn. A soon to be 4-year-old fighting game to add a substantial reworking of its online systems that would not be cheap, that would definitely cost a hell of a lot of money, and that they've already addressed in the past that, like, you know, at this time we're not going to do rollback, well, this is not going to happen. I really don't think that that's in the cards for the budget in any way of this version of the game, which is why I've kind of come to the conclusion that I want to play this character, right? And I'm going to play it online, most likely through the PC version and or Parsec, because we're just going to ignore most of the online systems the game already has because it's kind of frustrating. I really hope, right? I really hope that this game is done. I want Dragon Ball FighterZ to eventually reach that conclusion at some point so that the eventual can happen. This game isn't going to just be done in terms of the franchise. Dragon Ball FighterZ has established itself as a long-running thing that's going to sell a hell of a lot, no matter what they do in the future. Same thing that Xenoverse got multiple versions of the game, right? I want them to be done with this shit and give us a Dragon Ball FighterZ 2. We need Dragon Ball FighterZ 2 so that the game can get a new budget, an updated budget, a next-gen version, and then also could have consideration for rollback netcode. That rollback netcode can happen, 100% can happen. The chance of it happening outside of a sequel, insanely unlikely. Like, if it happens, it's a fucking miracle from God, thank you Santa Christmas type shit. Like, it would take so many stars to align for the current version of Dragon Ball FighterZ to actually get a rollback update of some kind. The only way it could possibly happen is if there's a sequel announced and they're testing the rollback in this version of the game, they add it retroactively for Dragon Ball FighterZ, like, 1. But we already know of there being a Dragon Ball FighterZ 2. Like, that's, in me, that's like a realistic scenario of DBFZ 1 getting a rollback update. That's like the only way it could happen. But at that point, you're just like, oh, well, Dragon Ball FighterZ 2, I'll just give me fucking that. I'll just take Dragon Ball FighterZ 2. So I would like to say that this has me, like, kind of excited for future characters in DBFZ 2, because I do want to play more characters, and I hope she's fun, and we're gonna give it a shot and see what the heck it's like, because there has been some incredible characters that have shown up in this game that are genuinely amazing, like some fighting game characters that I can absolutely point out and like, this shit is badass and I love it and it's super fun, and I got to give credit for Dragon Ball FighterZ for creating some of those characters. But I want it to end. I want it to end, because the longer this goes, just the longer it's going to take for an eventual DBFZ 2 to to become a reality of some kind. That needs to happen. Like, it just fucking needs to happen. It's the only way you're going to get Bandai Namco to be on board with a revamped rollback netcode situation. It's a Bandai Namco game, budgeted by Bandai Namco, made by Arc System Works. Arc System Works will definitely be including their new rollback package, like their new rollback offerings, in the budget consideration for the next game, and that'll get approved. Like, it will. Even though Bandai Namco has not been on board with like the majority of their fighting games going forward, I think it's an eventuality that Bandai Namco will. They will eventually adopt the things that everybody else is doing. There might be a couple more characters after Labcoat. I honestly think there could be as well. To me, this screams the last season of Killer Instinct. Killer Instinct did not get a season 4. Killer Instinct got a season 3.5. And what did season 3.5 entail? Two technical clone characters? It had like a unique version of Hisako and a unique version of Fulgore that were turned into Shin Hisako and Kilgore. They used a lot of existing assets to make those characters, but they were hyper-tuned and they played dramatically different. Like, they don't play anything like their original characters. They look different when they're in combat and they play different when you play them. That's pretty much what's happening here with Android 21. And I think there's a very high likelihood that that's already happened. That's already littered throughout this whole game. Like, the majority of Vegeta and Goku's share a shit ton of assets between them all. Like, let's be real. Dragon Ball FighterZ has already done that throughout a large majority of its existing roster. Not everybody, but a lot of this shit. There could be a Shin Piccolo. I don't know. What are the odds that the development of DBFC 2 isn't going well, so they're releasing more content similar to the Street Fighter V situation? I mean, it's likely. It's hard to say, man. I don't know. Bandai Namco keeps everything really tight. I can't really say. All we know about the Dragon Ball FighterZ license, or the Dragon Ball license with Bandai Namco, is that they got to essentially pump out a big, new, substantial Dragon Ball game, like, every year. So that means it's not Dragon Ball FighterZ 2 anytime soon, you know? It's gonna be some time, man. Unfortunately. I was hoping it was going to be sooner than later. I was hoping they were going to be at sort of the beginning of this console generation, but maybe not. This comes with a bit of reluctance, because while I would like to be super excited about more Dragon Ball FighterZ characters, I know that the existence of more Dragon Ball FighterZ characters just means that we're going to have to wait longer and longer for DBFC 2 and the eventual things that we really want in the game, which is like rollback netcode. Everyone's complaining about it now. It's hard not to be on board with that situation.